Imagine you have many spread out particles that you want to gather at a specific location in a maze. Your particles are all moved by an external magnetic field, so they all move in the same direction, unless their path is blocked. In joint work between the University of Houston in the USA and the Technical University of Braunschweig in Germany, we developed tools to efficiently gather particles. Several medical conditions could be treated by delivering large numbers of medication-loaded particles to specific areas of the body. For example, many cancers could be treated by targeted delivery of chemotherapy. The particles used are mechanically passive and cannot move autonomously. Instead, they are often controlled by an external global force that acts uniformly on all particles. Our paper shows how to use a time-varying magnetic field to gather particles to a desired location. Our particles are ferrous and are controlled remotely by a global field generated by electromagnets. The hardware setup uses pairs of orthogonal coils to generate rotating magnetic fields that roll the particles in desired directions. We restricted movement to one of eight cardinal directions. To train agents without requiring large numbers of hardware experiments, we built a simulator, which behaves like our real-world hardware. Our previous work repeatedly used an algorithm that merged two particles. Here, the green particle is moved to the purple one. We repeat until all particles are gathered. These algorithms work well in a simplified setting, where particles stay together after collision. Unfortunately, our hardware particles don't always stay together after being merged. To make progress, we constructed a simulation model that better represents the hardware system, then used reinforcement learning to train an agent to gather particles at a desired position. Here we show four simultaneous simulated experiments. On the left, the particles are shown in yellow, moving in a light blue maze. The goal location is circled in red. Particles have a simplified physical model that models collisions, individual masses, and speeds. On the right is the observation data the agent receives. Non-black pixels are particles. The observation uses frame stacking, so green shows new locations for particles, red shows old locations, and yellow are particle locations in both frames. The observation data is noisy, with noise modeled to match the hardware experiments. To demonstrate the effectiveness of our simulation, we performed an ablation study. We want to gather the particles quickly, so this plots the mean episode length as a function of millions of training steps. We cut off episode length at 2,000 steps. Our baseline performs the best. Our baseline uses a noise curriculum that increases noise as training progresses. Without this noise curriculum, training doesn't work as well. We use frame stacking to convey dynamic information about particle movement. Without frame stacking, performance falters. Performance is much worse if the simulation does not have noise. At right, you can see the network overfitting to the noiseless simulator. To represent camera effects, our simulator adds artifacts during a shifting and scaling process of the observation. Without these alterations, the agent performs poorly on a system with these artifacts. If we train using particles without a physical model, performance is poor. Finally, our particle simulation uses more frames per second than the hardware system. An agent trained with a high frame rate performs poorly with less frames per second. We perform a similar ablation study on our hardware system. Here, the y-axis is the number of particles not yet at the goal, which we plot as a function of time. The number of particles is estimated by counting pixels. We run our baseline three times. The dark line is the mean. If we remove frame stacking, our agent has less information about particle movement and performs worse. Without a noise curriculum, gathering takes, on average, 90 seconds longer. With agents trained without noise, the particles were often still not gathered after 4 minutes. The hardware experiments qualitatively match the simulated model, showing that our system can overcome the domain shift from simulation to hardware experiments. Here you see both a top-down and a side view of particles being gathered. The particles have an average radius of 0.1 millimeters and are made of iron oxide. The workspace is laser cut from acrylic and measured 100 millimeters by 100 millimeters. The magnetic field rotates at 4 Hz with a magnitude of 3 millitesla. We extract particle positions by thresholding the overhead camera image. This data is then sent to the agent. The hardware experiments demonstrate fast convergence and robustness to both sensor and actuation noise. Experiments are repeated with 2 different workspaces and goal positions. The training process is independent of both. Agents are trained using the proximal policy optimization algorithm and receive reward based on the distance of the particles to the goal. This reward is normalized to ensure the same reward independent of the workspace size. The agent itself uses a multi-layer feed-forward network with convolutional layers for feature extraction. Training the agent for one of these experiments requires 120 million steps of training, which takes about 3 days. We show the reliability of this approach by repeating the same experiment with the same agent and randomly distributed particles 10 times in one of our workspaces. In every case, the agent successfully delivers all particles to the goal location. In the future, there are many exciting avenues, like expanding to 3-dimensional instances, or instances which also simulate blood flow. Our paper presents methods for gathering particles in a 2D maze using reinforcement learning agents to plan gathering sequences, and an external, time-varying magnetic field for particle control. We presented an innovative approach that robustly and efficiently gathers particles in a hardware platform. The gathering time required was reduced from tens of minutes to tens of seconds. We made the code available on GitHub. We hope that sharing the code will encourage extensions and serve as a benchmark for the reinforcement learning community for particle gathering. Thank you.